of all the things which can kill a goat enterprise, buying in the wrong genetics at the beginning is the number one thing. You won't discover it for 10 years, and by that time you'll be sick of it and you'll be gone. So number one, make sure you get the right genetics. Genetics are absolutely fundamental to selecting the right goats. They are hugely adaptable, and there's an enormous range of genetic characteristics. A goat which is the right goat for some places is the wrong goat for other places and other enterprises. And therefore you've got to be very conscious of selecting the right animals for your purpose. That's why we say fit for purpose animals.
Before you start, you have an end goal in mind, and then you'll find the goat that suits that end goal. In Queensland, the opportunity to harvest rangeland goats free range has dissipated to nothing. We developed a fence to keep a few nannies in to try and get a breeding herd. We started off with these rangeland goats, and we couldn't get them to grow quick enough. So we had to find a breed of goat to get a quick growing kid.
The rangelands, we're crossing with a Kalahari sire and producing a rangeland Kalahari cross at the moment. The rangeland brings in a little bit of that mongrel and survivability factor. The Kalahari brings excellent meat quality carcass as a lean carcass, and also is bringing in the camouflage colouring, the red cut that blends in with our country, which makes them less susceptible to predation, particularly the aerial predation. And the Nubian brings in extra legs, a bit of height. It can walk out better for feed and water. It can reach a little bit higher for browse. And it also has a very good milk capacity. So crossing that with the Kalahari brings the best of both worlds. And at the moment, we're running on about 180% kidding rate for this season. For our kids, even though it has been incredibly dry conditions.
It's very clear now that the best looking animal is not necessarily the most productive animal. So you have to look beyond the appearance of the animal to what its actual production characteristics are. That's number one. We believe there's a need and an opportunity to produce significant numbers of billies, bucks, for rangeland producers and farmland producers. And those animals must be fit for purpose, adapted to the requirements of the producer and the area that the producer's in. And rangeland ones will be different from farmland ones. And out of the genetic pool we currently have, we can produce both those bucks.
Do your homework. Do your research and find out what is suitable to your local environment. Find another local producers in your area, talk to them. It's not a case of one goat fits all environments.
Don't give up after the first failure. You will have several failures, but at the end of the day you will end up with a product that suits your environment, and you will be happy farming it.